Shalom Obracha, I would like to wish you a good day. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit today. I have a small flu. And Baruch Hashem, it's not Corona. It's okay. Today, I wanted to tell you a beautiful story that the Gemara said about Nakdimon Ben Gurion. One day, there was no water in Israel. As you know, three times a year, the Jewish people, they come to arrest Yerushalayim. And one day, one of the three holidays, you know, they had the obligation to come. On Pesach, on Shavuot, on Sukkot. One day there was no water for all the millions of people that come to Eretz Israel. And Nakdimon Ben Gurion, he went to see a non-Jewish man that he lived in around Jerusalem. He was a Roman, was very rich. He had a lot of field of water, and he asked him, if you can give me your water, if you can give me your water for the people that come to Yerushalayim, and I promise you, after the holiday, I give you back the water. At that time, there was really, the weather was fabulous. No way that the water that will rain. And told him, okay, I give you the water for all your people, but I want you, beside the water, to give me a big amount of money. They made a deal, that's it. My friend, after the holiday, there was no water. There was no rain. And the guy was very happy. Now he's going to become billionaire. Because Nakdimon, he was a very rich man. And of course, he has to pay him a big amount of money. Nakdimon Ben Gurion, he went to the Beit HaMikdash, the day that he's supposed to pay. And he prayed to Hashem, Hashem, oh, what they did, I did it for you. Now there is no water. Please, Hashem, do me a favor, do a favor to your name. If next time, if I wouldn't do that, the Jewish people will not stay in Yerushalayim, you will go away. I did it for you. So please Hashem, do for your name, do for Am Israel, that it is going to rain now, so there is water for everybody. And for the goy, for the nation. And there was no water. The goy, he came to Nakdimon. He told him, well, prepare the money. He said, I still have the day. In the afternoon, before the night, the rain came and he filled up all the places that he needed money. Rain. So, of course, the goy was very angry, very angry. He told Nakdimon, well, there is no sun. It's dark because of the weather was very dark. So Nakdimon, he went again to the Beit HaMikdash. He prayed to Hashem, Hashem, do me a favor. Bring back the sun. So he will not tell me we cheated him, that we paid him back the water as we promised him. We give him a small amount of money, but not the big amount. And Hashem, he did another miracle. And Hashem, he sent a big wind to send away all the cloud. That was a bigness. That was Nakdimon Ben Gurion. But you have to know something, my friend. Usually, this kind of stories, it happens only when you have emuna on HaKadosh Baruch Hu. A lot of times I think, why the rabbis at that time, they did not pray? I know one thing, when there is no rain, we pray. So why only one person had to pray? Nakdimol Begoyon. Why only him? He wanted the Beit HaMikdash twice. And we saw it was a big miracle. Why? I know, I remember in Morocco when there is no rain, all the rabbis, they scream, they pray, they fast. And here we saw only Nakdimol Begoyon. It's incredible, it's hard to believe. Why? My friend, you have to know something. What Nakdimol Begoyon did, every Jew can do it. I think the Torah wants just to teach us that Nakdimon Begoyon, he was a billionaire. He could have paid the water from his own money, from his own pocket, but he went to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Why the others didn't pray? Well, it's a mistake why he didn't pray. Because maybe they believe so much in Hashem, and they knew that anyways, something is going to happen. You understand? But sometimes, we are not allowed to rely on other people. Every time you have a problem, you have to pray. You have a problem, don't rely on rabbis. Don't rely on others. You have a problem, pray. Hashem bless you, and Hashem give you all what you need. Amen.